One of this year's most fascinating and consequential races kicked into high gear today. The Florida Republican Governor Rick Scott made it official. He's running for Senate, challenging the incumbent Democrat Bill Nelson.
So today, with my wife by my side, I'm announcing I am running for the U.S. Senate for the great state of Florida. We can change Washington. We must change Washington. We will change Washington. Together, let's get Washington to work.
Now, Scott's approval ratings are up, and his response to the Parkland shooting included signing new gun controls. Democrats can't lose this seat if they hope to win back the Senate next year. So they wasted no time welcoming Scott with this tough online ad.
When his title was governor, he cut $1.3 billion from education, raised property taxes, and refused federal health care aid that would have covered almost a million Floridians. Now, Rick Scott wants to be called senator. But if he didn't look out for you here, he won't look out for you there.
With Scott officially in, CNN moving the Florida race from lean Democratic to toss-up. Our new rankings also include this shift, the race to replace the Tennessee Republican Bob Corker, moving from likely Republican to lean Republican. So a competitive race in Tennessee, but let's stay in Florida. This is going to be now one of the big marquee races of the year. Rick Scott, Republicans look at him and say he's won two really close, tough races. That's a good thing because he's battle-tested. We could flip that and say he won those two races just barely in 2010 and 2014, red years. Red wave years against pretty weak opponents, let's be honest. So you could look at it and say, is he up for this in a blue year?
Yeah, and it's going to be one of the most expensive races in the country. It's going to be one of the closest races in the country. Bill Nelson himself has not had as formidable of a challenger as Rick Scott. So this is going to be a tough race for him, too, undoubtedly. I think when you look at the map more broadly, this is... the Democrats have a very good chance of picking up the House. It's a very significant chance. But on the Senate side, it's really going to be very difficult for them to take back the Senate. They still have a number of incumbents in red seats who are fighting to just keep their seats. Florida could be one that flips. So we could see an election day where Democrats take the House, but Republicans narrowly keep the Senate, but still a long way to go.
This is incredibly telling to me as Rick Scott looks at this race. Number one, he signed the bill. He signed the bill the NRA opposed. Rick Scott has been a gun rights guy. He's been an NRA guy. He signed a bill that includes new gun controls. The NRA doesn't oppose him. He understands his state is becoming more of a suburb. Number two, Politico asked the question to him in an interview, are you a Trump Republican? Rick Scott has been a strong supporter of this president. The president has been a strong supporter of this governor. Here's what he said. I consider myself Rick Scott. I don't consider myself any type of anything. If it's good for us, I'm going to support what the White House wants to do. If it's not good for Florida, I'm going to oppose. I'm not going to be a rubber stamp for anybody. That tells me this is a guy who thinks in this blue year, the best way for him is to not move to the middle, but to be not so far right. Is that fair?
I think so. I mean, these are two very well-known commodities here, so voters will be able to remember, two terms of Rick Scott and whether they want to get rid of Bill Nelson over that. I don't think that they will. I think that right now the environment is so Democratic, lean Democratic, that this isn't going to be the race that decides or that flips the Republicans this year.
But you can bet that quote's going to end up in an ad and layered over some things that Rick Scott has done that aligns himself with Trump. I mean, they're going to be tying Trump to him at every turn, in part because of the amount of money that is going to go into Florida. I mean, we can't stress enough how expensive this race is going to be and how Democrats are going to be looking for any advantage to keep this state blue.
And you can also imagine how that quote might turn up in Donald Trump's clips at some point and make him angry. I mean, the degree to which he is willing to and does engage in a forceful way in this race is going to be determinative in some way for Rick Scott.
And I talked to Bill Nelson about the gun control issue. He believes that cuts in his favor very much because he's got bad ratings from the NRA. He thinks that's actually going to help him, particularly in southern Florida. We'll see how it deals with Rick Scott.
A couple of big House races in Florida as well this year. It's going to be a great state to watch in a midterm election year with much to watch from now to November 3rd.